Hello everyone. I've managed to get the documentation printed. I had it already on my hard drive, but I wasn't sure where we were in the game, so I didn't have it to hand the last time. Anyway, this is from DocTabasco's Game Facts walkthrough. He's the only one that's actually done a walkthrough, and the question that was asked in his FAQ was, "What the funk? I can't find 12 plus isotopes in the hydro station. It's driving me insane." And the answer that was given was, "Yeah, about that. See, Midway isn't perfect, especially not their level designers. I'll leave the rest to my friend, former product analyst on the Dr. Muto team, Frederick Mora." Now, Dr. DocTabasco emphasizes in his fact the following. Remember, former product analyst. This isn't an official statement, but the guy's name is in the credits, so it can't be far off. Now, what he said was this: "Those missing isotopes that you are talking about was a problem that even the testers for this game had a hard time finding. Generally, the isotopes the testers had missing were in the underwater cave mazes you had to swim in before you had to do the mission where you destroyed submarines. But here's the even funnier part. You'll hate the designers for this. As hard as it is to navigate within the maze, some isotopes were accidentally placed too close to the walls or the floor, so that you literally had to scrape along the wall or the floor to get it. You had to rotate your camera to a certain view to even begin to see it. This problem happened because designers generally placed their isotopes in the world in a haphazard manner. But sometimes artists would change the art of a level, and the designers, being the geniuses that they are, decided not to make note of where all of them were placed and could not fix it. Also, when this design issue of missing isotopes was brought up, the producers told us that hey, as long as the player gets 80% of the total in-game isotopes, then that's all they really need. There's nothing if you get the 100% of the isotopes. It's still the same reward as getting 80% of the isotopes. I know this sounds lazy, but they were pressed for time and just wanted to ship the product. A bit of a disappointment for the completionists, but at least you know what the deal is." And I'll place a link to DocTabasco's FAQ in the description, and also as annotation on the video itself. So I've given him credit where credit is due, because this came from him. So, and if I look on the master plan, it says there's the hydro station, and the submarine level, that's the dam subs, destroy all four of the submarines to cut off their signals. So I mean, it's definitely this area, except I don't know where exactly, and there is no like description of it. So I guess we'll just have to carry on. Oh yeah, and another thing, Van Bacon gave me a tip using the Spiny Docfish, and that was to press the R2 button. Like so. Alright, I just have to get the hang of it. That was like a quick turn, is it? Yeah, but I died, so I mean. Alright, I need to get the hang of that. Cool. Thanks for that tip. Probably makes things a lot easier. So if I get attacked from behind. What? Oh, wait a minute. Why is he... Okay. Get my bearings again. Alright. So, in the water we go. And immediately I'm being attacked by this critter. Oh, wait a minute. He spins as well. Need to get a bit of a bearing here for a sec. Coast clear for now. Alright, I've got my bearings back. And I'm not quite sure what I need to do. Let me check the master plan. Busted nuts. Break all the spiky balls and earn a prize locked deep below. Pop the caps, destroy the breather caps, and pump out your reward. Secret caves. It is a secret, you know. Slacker. Damn subs. Destroy all four of the submarines to cut off their signals. Yeah, okay. Memory like a fish. Three unique symbols activated by the amazing spiny dockfish. Damn dirty ape. Use Doxilla to climb across the monkey bars in the cavern area. Up for air. Use the pocket rockets to nail the weak spots in the pumping machinery. Okay. Didn't you say that we had to raise the monkey bars or something? I see some monkey bars here. And there's a Goma as well. Let me just get some health. Lots of health here. Oh, what's this? Is this a new fauna? Okay, yeah it is. Whoops. Hey you. What? Quite sure how to do the L2, but or the R2. Alright, you can spin. Okay, so you like use R2 and barge into him. That needs a bit more practice, to be honest. Whoops. Wait a minute. Is that fauna, is it? Yes, it is. Cool. The camera's a bit awful here. Okay. Alright. So I did a bit of practicing with that R2 button. It's a bit tricky, nonetheless. So I'm just going to carry on now. Hopefully you won't fail as much as last time. That ape section was just incredibly hard. Previous area. Alright, so I had to do something here, isn't it? Oh, wait a sec. What's this one? Why is that one up? Or maybe I hit it already. I need to hit these spiky balls, isn't it? Ah, okay, cool. I must have hit that one by accident then.
Okay, now where in the fuck do those monkey bars think they are going?
Okay, that was weird. And we got our first Terra piece in the Hydro Station, I guess. I wonder what that Goma's for. I'm not seeing a Goma switch or anything around here. Let's get these two crates. I think I'm going to be needing it. Oh, what's in these pipes? Is there anything in these pipes? Isotopes, cool. Whoops. Oh, there's more pipes here. Alright. I think getting a slight hang of this again. It's the one in here. Yep. Alright, so I guess there's only one way to go and that's that way. Oh. Yeah, I'm doing this a bit slow, because obviously I don't want to keep dying. Whoops. I hope you don't mind that I'm taking my time a bit. Well, obviously I want to progress, of course, but what the? Do I spin through this or what? There's an isotope very close to this fan. Didn't damage him. Can I break that? No, I guess not. Yay, got through. Cool.